7 years. So my topic for today is 10 awesome things in PHP. It's a very light topic. There are many useful PHP functions. So as a developer, it is not necessary that we must know all the functions available in PHP. So I've randomly picked 10 out of them. Okay. Some of you must be familiar with it, but there are a few others who have just started their careers in PHP or who haven't come across it. So I'll dive into the first function. First is check DNS RR. I'm not sure how many of you have heard of it. Is there anybody have used it before? Okay. Okay, this function basically helps to check the DNS records of the host name or the IP address that is provided into the function. So it is a network type function. It's available in PHP 4, 5, and 7. So it takes in two parameters. One is a host, and the other is a type. Host is the IP address or the host name itself, and type is a DNS type. So if you didn't pass any DNS type, by default, it takes MX. That's a mail exchange type. So it returns true if the record exists. Otherwise, it will return false. So here's a simple example. So this function is partially does a partial validation of an email address. So what it does is that it will extract the domain name from the email, and it pass it to the check DNS RR function. If the domain exists, it will return true. Otherwise, it will return false. So this will help you to find out if the host name exists. I mean, the DNS, the domain exists. You can check the validity of the email. My next function is extract. Extract is used to import the variable into the current symbol table. It's a very cool function. You can reduce the steps while programming. It's widely used in WordPress, if I'm not wrong. It's an array type function. It is available in PHP 4, 5, and 7. So it takes in three parameters. One is the array. Array is an associative array. If you pass a numerically indexed array, it may not produce any output unless you use some extract flags with it. Flags are used to treat the invalid or numeric keys and collisions. Next is prefix. Prefix is, if you didn't pass anything, it is null. It is used with certain flags. It returns a number of variables that is imported to the current symbol table. So here's an example. So this is an associative array with my first name and my last name. So I'm extracting my first name and last name with just with the using the array key as the variables. Okay. Is it clear? Yeah. Okay. So next is usort. Usort is used for sorting an array using a user-defined comparison function. So the comparison function must return an integer which is less than, equal to, or greater than 0 if the first argument is less than or equal to or greater than the second one. It's again another array function. So it's available in PHP 4, 5, and 7. So it takes in two parameters. One is array, that is the input array. And second is the user-defined function itself. The comparison function. So it returns true on success, false on failure. So here's an example. So this example consists of a list of people's first name, last name, and their age. So I've defined a compare last name function. So basically what the function does is that it compares sorts the array based on their last name in alphabetical order. So it will return a sorted array alphabetically with based on their last name. So this is the output. I formatted it for your better understanding. Okay. Next is function get args. This is a very common function that is used. It is used to return the list of arguments in PHP in the function. So it's a function handling function. It is available in PHP 4, 5, and 7. This is a syntax function get args, it takes voids. It returns the list of arguments in the function. So PHP takes, it helps to retrieve the, it takes arbitrary number of arguments. So here's a simple function that accepts arbitrary number of arguments. So it uses function func get args to retrieve the arguments, and I've looped the arguments to print them. So in the first time when I call it, I just pass one argument. So it prints out the one argument. And the next time I pass three arguments, it prints all the three arguments. Next is getenv. Getenv is a PHP options or info function. It's used to get the value of the environment environment variable. It's used in PHP 4, 5, and 7. So the parameter is just a variable name. It returns a value of the environment variable, or false if the environment variable doesn't exist. So here's a simple example. So I'm fetching the remote address using getenv. Alternatively, you can use a super global like $_server or $_env. It's basically the it basically serves the same purpose. Okay. Next is globe. Globe is used to locate the path name that is matching a pattern, particular pattern. It's a file system handling function. It is available in PHP 4.3 and greater. So it takes in two parameters. One is a pattern and the other is a flag. Pattern is a pattern of whatever the pattern is. And flag is optional. There are many flags that can be used. You can refer the PHP manual for that. So the return value will be the array of the match files. And an empty array will be returned if there's no file found. Or it will return false if there is in case of any error. So here's a simple function example which retrieves all the files that matches this particular pattern. So it will list the file names and the file size. So it can also take multiple patterns. So I have demonstrated another example which can take the multiple files. So this is the case where you might have to use a flag. So globe_brace is a flag which expands this braces to search for these two patterns. Next is error_getLast. This is also a very common function. So this is used to get the last occurred error. It's an error handling function. It is available in PHP 5.2 and greater. It returns an associative array returning the last error. So it returns null if there hasn't been an error yet. So the array of the array that it returns will have the type, message, line, and the file as the keys. So if there's any if the error is with the function in the message, it will state the function name itself. Next is serialize. Serialize is a PHP native function. It generates a storable representation of a value. These days, I think JSON is very popular. So to add support, JSON encode and JSON decode is added into 5.2 and greater. When you pass a value into serialize, you must properly sanitize it, because when you unserialize it, there are chances for security vulnerabilities. So in PHP 7, I think they have introduced allowed classes to prevent this. So it's a variable handling function. It's available in PHP 4, 5, and 7. Okay. So it returns a string containing byte stream representation of a value. So here's an example. Basically, I've just passed an array, and it will retrieve the string, which is in byte stream representation. Okay. Next is check date. This is a date time function. This is used to validate a Gregorian date. Gregorian date is a Western date. So it is PHP, it is available in PHP 4, 5, and 7. It takes in three parameters, the month, day, and year. It also validates the leap year. So it returns true if the date is valid, otherwise it will return false. And you have to define the parameters correctly, otherwise it may not return the proper result. So here's an example. Here I've passed the date June 31st, 2016, and it will return false because 31st June has only 30 days. And I've checked if this year is a leap year, so I've passed 29th February, so it will return true. This is the last one, Levenshtein. Levenshtein is used to calculate the Levenshtein distance between two strings. So it's a string function. Levenshtein distance is the number of the minimum characters that has to be inserted, deleted, or replaced to match the first string to the second string. So it's a string function. It is available in PHP 4.1 and greater. So it takes in two parameters, string 1 and string 2. So the function will return the return the Levenshtein distance between the two strings. So here's an example. First string is caret, and second string is caret with an additional R and T. So when you pass these two strings into the function, it will generally return the Levenshtein distance between these two strings. Okay, so that's it. You can reach me at Twitter, Brita_Alex, and my Gmail address, brita.alex@gmail.com. Thank you.